And welcome back, guys. Welcome back to Final Fantasy X HD Remaster. I have been doing a little bit of blitzball off screen. Again, you'll probably have seen the videos by now, or I'm hoping you have. If not, I've got quite a fair few blitzball videos to come now. I've at least done, I don't know, eight or nine, ten matches maybe. So, but just to quickly enter blitzball for a minute. Don't worry, we're not going to play blitzball. But if you look at my number one first place prize, you can now see the status reels have now appeared. So I will be going back into doing blitzball and doing another league to win my status reels. Now this one might be a bit of a tough one, because now remember, a lot of the blitzball players have actually leveled up now, including us. And if you guys haven't seen some of the matches we've had some pretty epic wins. And I've got to say, I think we won every single match, and Tidus was the top goal scorer. If you don't like blitzball because you're not really sure how to play it, then watch some of my videos to blitzball. I'm not a pro at blitzball, but I can maybe throw you in some tips here and there. And I don't remember which video, but one of the videos actually do give you a really good tip on how to actually win a blitzball match. It's kind of a bit of a glitch in the game, but if you don't know what I'm talking about, be sure to check them out. But anyway, I figured we're gonna get on with some more of the game. Now, honestly, I'm not sure what I'm going to do, but what I'm thinking, is to just show you guys where I would level grind if you wanted to boost up some EXP. I can't promise you it'll be the fastest trick, and by no means this is the only trick, but it was one trick that I felt gave me a boost of levels really early on, after just reaching the end of the game, if that makes sense. So as soon as I'd done Zanakund and the storyline with Unaleska and everyone, then when I went to the Camlands, which is where we're going to be heading.
Yeehaw! Here we go!
Thank you, Sid. Then I actually found it was a good place to kind of get a lot of sphere levels. Now, you can do it several ways. You can go up to, you know, you can go to the Omega Ruins and grind there. But they were, even for me, they were quite hard to kill those enemies there. Or you can go and grind it, you know, grind in the Carmans if you want. You know, you can grind anywhere as long as it's good EXP. Or, alternatively, what I do. Now, there is some good enemies you can grind with on, or shall I say, in the Battle Arena. Or the Monster Arena even, not the Battle Arena. That's not Final Fantasy VII Neo. But the Monster Arena has some pretty decent levels there. Let me show you. Boom, boom, boom. Every time this music plays, I just want to go... Boom, 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 boom. So, I'll show you what I normally grind on anyway. Sounds really kinky, you know, but it's not like that. Promise. Now, don't look at me like that. It's not what I meant. Now, save your game, by all means. I've just saved mine in the, I'll just save it one more time in case. If you do seem to wipe for whatever silly particular reason, then at least we know we've just saved our game right outside to where we wiped. Boink. Right. So, what I... Oh, okay then. I've researched the fiends you brought me and put together an absolutely wicked bomb. Turbo Ethers, nice. Do you know what? Just for funsies, let's give it a go. Kamari, the man, the myth, the legend. Get out of my party, man. Let me think what I want to do. Don't think threatens going to work, but I'm just going to try it. Nope. Kamari, get out of my party, man. I wish I can give you something to do on your way out, but see you. Fire gem. Armor break. Nope. Power break. Nope. Strange how he only just sort of powered up or enlarged and now. Okay. I'm sensing something nasty is about to happen. Pyra? Hurts. It hurts, but I don't know if we can actually win this fight, but we'll try it. Don't think there's much else when we magic break him. Nope. Can we mental break him? 26,000 damage, but no. It may just explode. Shining Gem. Fire Ragger, oh, okay. Ooh, wow, that hurt. And he didn't do as much damage as he'd like because he was weak. So we can get him down. That's what she said. He might just explode now. Quick hit. Ultimate. Oh, wow. This could be game over. In fact, I think it will be game over. Unless it does like 8,000 damages exactly on all three of us. Nope, we are dead. Now, I don't mind trying that because as much as we're all weak, we can just go yoink and try again if we wanted to. Chap, did you get anyone else? I need a few more of those hard-shelled guys. I'm sure you know where to find them. Well, yeah, two areas. Now, anyway, going back to what I was going to tell you guys to grind on, a good one we could do is if you go to... Now, you could try Catchers in the Thunder Plains. Let's just see how much AP we get. So it's baby AP, right? Because it's obviously a baby capture. That's fine. I know that seems a bit silly for me to try, but you'd be surprised because I go to fight monsters and fight the capture in Bicanel. Obviously, I'm going to get overkill. Look at the AP now. It's a bit better. Now, obviously for me, it's not that much AP because I've leveled up quite a lot, but it's quite a fair amount of AP. Was there another catcher? I thought there was. Tombry. That might not be a bad one either. Let's just have a look. We kind of experiment here a little bit. Oh, is he going to kill him now with Karma? I think he might do, you know. No, not quite. Okay, so Titus killed him, that's fine. That's how much AP we get. So. See, the Catcher in Bicanel was actually easier to kill than the Tombry. Now, let me try something else. Let's try Capture King. I don't even know if I've ever killed him before. I'm not sure actually now. I want to find something that protects against 1,000 needles, really. Protect on one character. Let's put Protect on myself. And then let's put Protect on Titus. Find it there. Protect on Titus. Let's just see what he does. Oh, 100,000 needles, sorry, not 10,000 needles. Well, that's fine that he dies because he didn't even have Protect on anyway. so we can speed things up a little bit. I mean, even to be fair, when you think about it, even Protect's not going to really stop that damage, really. Just trying to think what I can do that to either slow him down or something. There we go. 100,000 needles this time. Protect didn't even do anything, did it? Ah, you see, he counters with that as well, does he? Right. Oh no, he doesn't. Well, we might be able to grind through it. I just want to kind of see how much AP we get. See what we can do here. See if Doom works. Don't think it will. No. 200 seconds, Jesus. Nah, that's him down. He's gonna have another turn. Wow, this is tough. There's not much else I can really do on him. I'm just trying to think if there's anything I can do. No, I don't think so. I mean, I'll try Darkness, Sleep or Silence on him, but that's if I even hit him. I mean, another way around it is getting Auto Phoenix. Mega Phoenix, bit of a waste, but I'll reload my game if I have to. Okay, well, I'm just kind of messing around here a little bit to see if we can at least try and get the... Oh my god. OP, man, OP. Nope. Is he gonna... Oh, he's gonna counter-attack with that, isn't he? Well, he counters, but it doesn't counter the same person. Let's go with Slice and Dice. I don't know how much HP he has, but I'm guessing a lot. Excuse me. No. I just wanted to kind of experiment to see how much EXP he would give us if it were he's been killed us now anyway, so... I'm gonna reload my save game a sec.
This is it.
Okay, so we know... Okay, so we know that the catch will give us a fair amount of EXP. Oh, cool. Oh, yeah, Turbo Ethers. No, we're not going to try that. Thank you. So... Let's have a look at who else we can fight. You see, I'm tempted to try some of these fights, I just don't know if I'm prepared for them. No, see, my best bet here is to say just grind the catchers. And what you could do is, if you're on PlayStation or PS2 or whatever, just press triangle. Triangle. And then go Tidus. Okay, we're missing this. This is quite embarrassing. Oh my god, lol. Okay, well, I was trying to show you guys something, but anyway, I've got... I need to take all of the Kimari out of the fight, so... Formation, Kimari... Whacker, that's better. Let's try that again. Now, what you do is if you go... Triangle with Auron... And then skip out Tidus, because basically triangle is like a defend. So it still classes a turn, and look, everyone gets some fair amount of EXP. Let's try it again. Or you could, what you could do is steal. Steal again, because it was Auron's having two turns here. Get rid of... press triangle on Tidus and then use Whacker to hit the catcher, and you can get another ton of EXP. Another level up each. Do that again real quick. So it's not the fastest way, but it's a way of controlling the speed that you get fights. Now what I'm going to show you here is something different as well. Is because Auron keeps having turns, because our agility is so high. What you could do is bring in Riku, and it could be a really good way to level up Riku. Let's have a look at that real quick. Formation, we'll take Auron out a minute and bring Riku in, because Auron's agility is way too high, he keeps having turns. Oops. Because I remember doing this on my old Let's Play of it all, with these three. So what you could do here is steal, defend on Tidus' turn, Whacker attack, fight's a bit quicker, and Riku should get, well, to be honest, Riku should be one of the guys that you level up anyway, because she's really good. Catch us by, I mean, by all means have a look at the weapons, but they're not going to beat the weapons you've got now. Steal, Tidus skip, Whacker turn, boom. And for some reason, my experience as well is that Whacker is actually really good at hitting the catcher. So if you're struggling to hit him, go try Whacker. I'm pretty sure he has a good amount of accuracy. Or obviously, he was someone who has a good amount of accuracy. Didn't mean to click that then. One more fight. So you can see the levels come in fairly fast. And if you're a fan of grinding, then by all means, go for it. And the reason why I choose Steel is because she actually steals... Yeah, she actually steals those, I forget the name of the items now, and I've just seen about five pop up on the screen. Chocobo Feathers, that's what I'm looking for, and they inflict haste. I don't think on the party, but on the single player, but they're still pretty handy anyway. And look, within, what, not even 5 minutes, we've got four sphere levels to use for Tidus. So that'll help you master the sphere grid that little bit quicker. Not a professional tip, and I know the video's sort of ran up. 20 minutes, well, near enough 20 minutes now, with me just showing you, you know, not much really, but just showing you how to grind these enemies. But I figure that if you guys are doing this part of the game, it's worth showing. Now, Tidus, no, sorry, Whacker is actually stuck here, so I'm actually have to move him. So so we shall move him. To be honest, it doesn't really matter where you move him now. But we'll move him here. Which is quite far away from where he is, but... Defense 3. Agility. Evasion, nice. And we're gonna get some magic. MP. Magic defense, and then he's gonna learn flare, which is quite funny because you know, wacko with flare, you know. Riku, continue up with her. So we've gained a few levels. So it's not, like I said, it's not the best way to level up, but it was just, in my experience, it was one of the simpler ways of leveling up, is to just repeat that method there. Also, I'll have to look into another video about this, but I also think that some of the monsters in the Monster Arena are going to be really good to level up. Well, not level up necessarily, but are good to go in, steal from, kill, and you can grind and get some better equipment and accessories. But I feel that I'm not quite strong enough to get that to that, you know, to that stage just yet. But if you're looking at tackling the Omega Dungeon, and you know, you want to make those fights a little bit easier. I mean, for example, you can see I've never really grinded, and that's my honest tip at the moment, is to say go Bicknell, Catcher. I can't really say anything else gives any really good XP. Really? Just trying to think here. Let's just see how much easy XP these give. Wow. That was Death Touch on her weapon. Does she get any better EXP? No, you see, still the Catcher does better. So, and that was in the Omega Ruin, so, or Omega Dungeon anyway. The Veruna doesn't have a great deal. Let's have a look here. Gonna do haste. We know he's gonna do haste. Oh no, he's not gonna do haste because he sucks. Get all into the action. I mean, you can try and level up all of your characters this way. Haste. Now he does haste. There we go. Overkill as well, so the boost of boost of AP. Let's have a try. It's a bit better EXP, but it wasn't as quick. Could probably have done two of those catcher fights in the same time as that, really. More. I mean, if you had auto haste on, it might be a bit quicker, but let's try haste real quick. Haste to go. Yeah, with haste to go on, you should be alright. Not enough to kill him, though. Tidus never got another turn. Now he does haste. And Tidus is an overkill. Boom. So, yeah, it's not too bad. I mean, it's okay, EXP. I mean, you're in control of the speed of the fight, so you can just quickly get in, click, 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 and do it. Let's do one more quick. Oops. That could have been pretty bad. And let's go in Mug. Far Plane Wind, so you could probably try and mug a few of these off him. Another Far Plane Wind. Here's the good speed things up. I mean, once Wacker and Auron get strong enough, I suppose you'll be killing a lot quicker anyway, but it's a bit of a no-brainer. Overkill. So I don't know, it's not too bad. I mean, you can try and do this off screen if you don't mind Netflixing it and getting a few levels that way. I mean, we're at 4 levels now. Each, are we? Each? Yeah, each. So it's another easy way of getting a bit of AP. But by all means, experiment, see how fast you can kill things. For me, I grinded on the catchers a long time ago, and they were just super easy for me to get levels up. Not so good in this one, because I think I'm a bit kind of overskilled from already. Wow. Wacky's just moved in, he's already got flare. So, I don't know. See what you guys, let me know if you guys have any, better ways to level up and stuff, because I don't know, you know? I actually thought the catcher one would be a lot better than it was for us, but never mind, no biggie. The Omega Ruins is probably your best bet for leveling up, but why go to the Omega Ruins when you can just go here and choose the enemy you want to fight, rather than risking getting a Malbra, you know? Oh, I'm very tempted to go and send Belgamine, but if I do, I won't be able to grind her. That sounds really, 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 really weird. But I won't be able to grind her for sphere levels, spheres in general. Not that I... Do I even need them? No, not really. Well, power spheres are actually quite low, actually, to be honest. Wow. But yeah, I could go and grind them. Didn't know I was that low on them. Let's go and have a look, real quick. But if I send her, I can basically get Yuna's ultimate weapon done, and that will be 4 ultimate weapons done out of the 7? 8. 7, yeah. Yeah, out of the 7 that we've got. So that's over halfway done. And then, of course, we're working on Whackers, which, as much as the league is quite a long league, so I think it's roughly 10 matches, so it's quite a lot of matches there. And even after we do those 10 matches, we'll have to do another 10 matches, and then apparently the Auroch reels should appear in the rewards, I believe, as well. Nope, I don't want to train one ever again. We already did that, thank you. Let's just see what we can grind on Belgamine with the unit. See if we can get any decent sphere levels. If we don't get anything decent, we're just going to send Belgamine and get Yuna's ultimate weapon, I think. Another one we could try to do is to try and get Kimari's. You see, again, with Kimari and Lulu, I almost said Luna. With Kimari and Lulu's, you see, as much as I don't want to grind the lightning and I don't want to do those butterfly quests, I'm honestly not going to use them, so I'm not overly that bothered anyway. But I feel for the achievement, I wouldn't mind getting it done as well. Actually, another thing we can do, and I haven't forgotten about them, is to try those, try the Dark Aeons.
If you've got what it takes to beat Sin, I should be no more than a bump in your path, right?
That is such a cheesy pose of all got going on there, haven't it? It just seems a bit kind of... Dunno. You know, just see Lulu's head there. I'll do my best. Let's go with... Ixion.
Very well. Now.
Very well. Now. Straight in. Choose your Aeon Well, Summoner.
Choose your Aeon Well, Summoner.
Okay, here we go. Who are we gonna choose? Have you guys ever seen these guys? Let's just see how they perform. I don't know what we get for Ixion, by the way, off top of my head. I can't tell you which sphere we're going to get, but I believe each one of them gives us a different sphere. I'm not sure if I ever sort of showcased the Maga Sisters, but if not, this is what they're like. Go, go, do as you will, or dismiss. So this is Cindy. So let's put... gotta go. Taking a break. So they choose what they want to do. Mindy, fight. Take a break. Okay then. Sandy, do as you will. I'll reflect. Okay then. Do as you will. Taking a break. Do as you will. Thundara. Not the smartest move. Not the smartest move. Ooh, Ixion evades. Yes, we saw that. Thank you. Combined powers. Oh, you see, that's combined powers is their overdrive. I don't want to use overdrive. Overkill, 42,500 damage. Yeah. Not bad at all. Overkill.
Stop.
Does Uni get EXP? Don't think so.
Ah, you have made some progress. And for that, I am glad. Take this. It may come in handy.
Power sphere. So, I mean, it's only 8. And I can keep going in and grinding these if I want, but I don't know.
If you've got...
No, we're not going to do that again. But yeah, pretty much, that's another thing we can do. If you're at the same stage as me, by all means, just send her if you don't really worry too much about the power spheres. I mean, it's something you're going to pick up over time anyway. And if you ever did struggle, by all means, just go to your, when I find it, equip. And just go to, say, I don't know, Tidus and go with... Oh, well, we don't have any because I've sold a lot of stuff. But, you know, is it the S-balls and stuff like that? Don't think I've got any now. Yeah, S-ball, S-blade, anything. Oh, S-blade, there you go. Oh, distal speed. But, you know, the strength one. But distal strength, you know, and you can just kill enemies, even if you go to Besaid and just start killing things there and easy peasy stuff. Or when you're capturing, you know, or get a capture weapon and put distal strength on it. And every time you capture, you'll turn them into a strength. You know, it's not something I would be greatly worried about. But... I suppose I'm just thinking about sending them now, or whatever I need to, in case I need to, I won't be able to do it, if that makes sense. So, anyway, I'm going to end the video there, as always. It's been the 30-minute mark, at least, or just gone over. So join us in the next video for some more of Final Fantasy X. So until then, see you then.